गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ करंट. सो इन दिस चैप्टर समवेयर यू विल जस्ट सी सम अदर नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट इज मूविंग चार्जेस एंड मैग्नेटिज्म. सो द थिंग्स इज द सेम. मूविंग चार्जेस मीन्स करंट वी आर टॉकिंग देयर. So, in the case of magnetic effect of current, in this whole of the chapter, actually we are going to put our concern on the moving charge or simple dynamic charge. We are just putting our concept there. As I told you in starting, we have four branch of physics in the case of electromagnetism. So first was electrostatic, second was magnetostatic, third was electrodynamic, fourth was magnetodynamic, and after that we have we will study electromagnetism. So here in this case we are just going to understand the concept of electrodynamics, means what will be the effect when any charge is moving, any current is flowing somewhere in our circuitry. So it has been seen that whenever a moving charge is flowing from somewhere or current is flowing from somewhere, then that set up a magnetic field around it, and that magnetic field deflect the magnetic compass or magnetic needles in the certain directions. So it shows that obviously the deflection of magnetic needle or magnetic compass on the presence of the current that is flowing through any wire, that is showing the same thing as whenever any magnet that is deflecting any compass or needle. So we can simply say that moving charges set up a current around it whenever it will flow there. Clear, I think. So first of all, our first topic is here, what is magnetic field? So previously in your class 10th student, you have understood already and you are aware of the magnet, its properties, magnetic field. So first again I will just start from the topic of magnetic field, because here we are not going to discuss about the magnet here, but all the property of magnet automatically that will be here by using the current. Clear? So magnetic field is that the space around a magnet, you have studied this thing, space around a magnet that can affect, that can you can say attract or repel any other magnet is known as its magnetic field. In the same way you can define it in terms of current. Magnetic field around a moving charge that can interact with any other magnet or magnetic compass needle, that is known as its magnetic field. Clear? So simple thing is that up to the reason to where it can affect any other charge particle, any other magnet, any other magnetic instrument, that is known as its magnetic field. Next thing, how we have known about the magnetic field through the current here. So for that Oersted set up an experiment there, and his experiment was that he has taken a magnetic needle. So suppose we have a magnetic needle this time, this is north direction, this is south direction. Obviously you know that the magnet has two pole, so it is it has two pole, north pole and south pole. So it is north pole and south pole, and now we have taken a wire in which I current is flowing. Suppose the current is flowing from south to north. So Suppose current is flowing from south to north, then in that case we have seen that whenever this current is flowing, and for the flow of current you can join a battery. I think this is wrong. Here a key you can attach. So current should be negative to positive, so we can just make it in this way. So this is our circuit, and where in any wire I current is flowing, and we have just kept a magnetic needle near it in parallel of this. So Oersted had seen that this magnetic needle start to deflect towards the west. So it means that its south pole that will go to far away, and North Pole will attract it towards this. And so in this way, if you will see now the position of magnet, then that is just like this. So here you can see that its South Pole is deflected in this way and North Pole is deflected in this way. So at some angle it is deflected. Suppose this was the primary position, original position. So it is deflected through some angle theta. So it means that whenever the current that is flowing through any wire, that can also deflect the magnetic needle. And previously it was proved that magnetic needle can be deflected only by the magnetic field. So it means that the moving charge or the current that is flowing in the wire, that can also set up a magnetic field around it whenever it is flowing. So here one thing I am telling you every time, here always current should flow in the circuit, charges should flow. Only we are talking about the electrodynamics here. Whenever the charges will stop, that time it will not provide, it will not set up any kind of magnetic field around it. So that thing you have to keep in your mind, students. Here we have discussed electrostatic before in the case of electric field, electric potential there. And if it will start to move, then it will set up a current, and what kind of property of that current has, we have discussed that in current electricity chapter. Now we are just again seeing what kind of magnetic effect that current can set up. So simply magnetic field can be generated by the moving charges. Clear, I think. So this is the effect and this is the experiment that Oersted has seen already. And also if you will see here, suppose the current is flowing from north to south, that time it is deflected towards east direction. So it means simple thing is that here deflection in magnetic needle that we are getting. So that is our main point. If deflection we are getting, it means that this current will set up a magnetic field near it. So this was the first experiment for the current that is setting up any kind of magnetic field around it. And after that we have started to study about the moving charges or current there. Next thing, how can you understand the direction in which this magnetic needle will deflect? So for that we have a direction rule, that is Ampere rule, or we are saying it snow rule or Ampere law. So or Ampere swimming rule, we are also saying it. So this rule is saying that suppose a man is swimming along the direction of a wire and current is entering at its feet. Suppose this is a man that is swimming and current is entering at its feet and it is leaving to its head. And if we will just put a magnetic needle in parallel of this man, then that magnetic needle will deflect towards the left hand of the man. So it means suppose we have a south and north pole is here. So in this case, this north pole of the magnetic needle, that will be deflected towards the, this is suppose this is obviously left hand of the man, this is right hand. So towards the left hand it will just deflect. It means that this magnetic needle will deflect in such a way here. South pole will in this direction, this one. So in this way we can understand the direction in which the needle will be deflected. Or if you will talk about the snow rule, so it is showing that if a current is flowing from south to north, first two things are showing. If current is flowing from south to north over a wire, then the deflection in magnetic needle will be towards the west direction. So simple thing, by using snow rule you can understand it. And also if you want to understand it for the north to south, so whenever current will flow from north to south over the wire, then magnetic needle will be deflected in east direction. So this is the rule that shows the direction of deflection of the magnetic needle. And that is very important thing, first key, where it is deflecting. So students, I think that the things we have discussed up to now, Oersted experiment and moving charges are setting up current, magnetic field, that is now clear. So, students, after the discussion of Oersted law, I think that is now clear. Why we are just going to discuss about the magnetic effect of current, because current can produce the magnetic field easily. So that's why we are going to just discuss. Before this, we have studied about the electric effect of the current. So in the case of current electricity, all the electric effects we have discussed there, what kind of things can affect it. So in this chapter, we are putting our whole of the concern on the magnetic effect of that current. And for that case, a law that an experiment that that established the fact that always the if there is any moving charge, there is flow of current, then due to that, obviously a magnetic field will be generated there. One more thing, student, later we will discuss about the varying magnetic field or varying electric field, but here. Due to any kind of electric field, whether the current is constant or current is varying with time, due to both of the cases, magnetic field will be generated here. Clear? I think that factor is very important. Why it is important? Later I will tell you in next chapter when we will discuss about the electromagnetic induction. So there it is very important concept. So just keep that factor in your mind here. Now the next law that we have to discuss here, that is Bio-Savart law. So sometimes we pronunciate it like Bio-Savart law. So whatever pronunciation is clear, just you are comfortable, you can use it. So for the case of Bio-Savart law, it is an empirical formula or experiment based result to calculate the magnetic field due to any current carrying wire, because it is already established by the Oersted that moving charges can produce magnetic field. Then what will be the value of that magnetic field? First, Bio and Savart, two scientists who was there, they will try to actually conduct an experiment for that, and experimental result they have put there. So for that case, they have taken a long conducting wire. Suppose we have a long conducting wire that has length, suppose L, and in this case they have taken a small element, current element here. So a small element of this wire, if you will take that, then this small element, as this wire is current carrying wire, so we call it current element. So it means that if suppose this length of this element is dl, then we can call that the current element has the length dl in which I current is flowing here. Now we want to just calculate the electric field, magnetic field at any point P due to this current carrying wire. So they first attempt to understand the magnetic field due to this small element of the wire. Means only you can say that if length of wire is very long, so this is just like a point for this point, then obviously due to that point, like length, what will be the value of magnetic field? And suppose we are just meeting these two points. This is a point O here and this is point P, on which we have to calculate magnetic field here. So due to a small element, suppose magnetic field is dB here. So what will be the value of dB, on which factor it is depending on? They have tried to understand that. Suppose the length between or position vector of P with respect to O, that is R here, and the current element that is making an angle theta with this OP, so and I current is flowing, dl is the length. Then they have seen that this magnetic field that is produced due to this small element dl at this point P, that is from the distance that is at the distance R from this point O, and that is making angle theta. This is depending on first the length of this small element. Means greater will be the current element, greater current it will carry, and greater magnetic field it will generate. So first, this is directly proportional to dl. Second, they have seen that this magnetic field produced at point P, this is directly proportional to the current that is carrying by this wire here. Greater will be the current, greater will be the magnetic effect there. So obviously magnetic field is directly proportional to this. Third factor that they have seen, this magnetic field is also depending on the angle that is forming between this current element and this position vector, that is OP here. So this is just like the sine theta, this is directly proportional to this form. Next thing on which it is depending on, they have seen that the value of this magnetic field at this point, this is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between these two points here. This is square of the r square, it's inversely proportional. Now if you will combine this whole of the formula, then that is known as Bias-Savart law here, and that we are using to calculate due to any conducting wire or any kind of conductors at any point, what will be the magnetic field there. Here one more thing, this I current is constant, you are seeing. So for the constant current here we are working here. So let's just summarize this whole one. So the dB can be written as I dl sine theta divided by r square. So this is the summarized form of the Bias-Savart law. And if you will use the proportionality constant, suppose this is k, so this will be idl sine theta divided by r square. And this constant, its value is later detected, that is rho 0 upon 4 pi. And its value is nearly obtained to be 10 to the power minus 7. And you can write down its unit by using here. One more thing, the magnetic field has the unit that is known as Tesla. So as it magnetic field and its work was basically a lot of work is done by the Tesla, that's why in honor of him we are using Tesla as a unit here. So obviously you can see from here what will be the value of K. So this will be dB into r square upon idl, as theta is unitless, so you can write in the terms of these three. So let's just write it. So if you will write the unit here, this will be Tesla meter square upon ampere into meter. So this meter will be cancelled out. Then obviously this is the unit of this one, Tesla meter per ampere. So this is the unit of this value. Clear? I think that is, there is no confusion in this section here. Now this mu zero. Mu zero is representing it property of the medium in which current is flowing, and also it is known as permeability of the medium. Like we have discussed in the case of electric field, permittivity of medium, that was showing how much electric field you can generate in that particular medium. So its permittivity just helps us to understand which medium is better for the production of electric field, which is not. So according to that, conductor, insulator, we can even arrange them in that way. Next thing, this permeability also tells us in which medium how much magnetic field you can generate there. Means greater will be the permeability, greater will be the magnetic field that will be generated by same amount of current here. Clear? I think means if we are just changing our medium, like dielectric media we are using, conducting media we are using for the flow of current, then due to the same current, same current element even, and same angle, its magnetic field will be changed in that medium. That is depending on this factor, permeability of the medium here. So it means that we can now write the Bias-Savart law as a complete. This is mu 0 upon 4 pi idl sine theta upon r square. Here one more thing, mu 0 is the permeability of free space. If you have to write permeability of any of the medium, then you can write in the place of mu 0, you can write only mu there, clear? Because it is changing with change in medium. So here we are trying to just discuss whole of the things for the free space here. One more thing you have to keep in mind, like we have discussed already in the case of electric field, these kind of things. So this is the formula to calculate the small magnetic field due to small current element at some distance r, that is making angle theta, by using this formula here. Clear? I think next thing in this case that how can we convert this formula in the vector form? As you know that magnetic field is a vector quantity, it has direction, it previously we have already shown the snow rule, and there we have seen that needle is deflected in a particular direction if current is flowing in a particular direction. If it is flowing from south to north, then it is deflecting only in west, it is not deflecting in east, means magnetic field is also producing in a particular direction. So to just see that, first let's convert it into the vector form. So you know that to convert any quantity in vector form, we can multiply just a unit vector to it. And if you will just write the value of unit vector, this will be vector upon its magnitude. So this is the position vector r and its magnitude is this small r. Now we can write this whole one, just write down. So this vector db, this is written as mu 0 upon 4 pi I and upon r cube. This all is a scalar quantity, and also sine theta is a scalar, but let's write sine theta in the last first. Here dl, the word you are seeing, dl is the small current element in which I current is flowing. So you can see that as it this element dl is showing in which direction current is flowing. So this has direction, we can say that this is a vector term here. So we are representing dl by the current element or vector element dl here. And also we have a vector quantity r, this is upon this. Now as you are seeing, this is just like the a b sine theta, and obviously this is a cross b form here. So in this case, this is mu 0 I upon 4 pi r cube, and this is dl cross r. We have this is db. So this is the vector form of the Bio-Savart law, that is very important also, and with the help of this one we can say what is the direction of the magnetic field that is produced by any current carrying wire there. So as from here these all terms are here scalar, so it means that the direction of dl cross r, that will be the direction of db. So previously in vector term, vector notation chapter already we have understood that in which direction, if we have suppose some C is equal to C A cross B, then what will be the direction of C, that we can understand easily. So here suppose that if we have conductor, and how can we understand the direction for that, we are using right hand rule here or right hand screw rule here. So for that case, suppose this is the thumb that you are seeing, this is the direction of current that is flowing in any current carrying wire, and this fingers that you are seeing, that is representing the direction of this one dl cross r. So this is the angle between current carrying wire and also this magnetic field. Obviously these two are representing the direction of magnetic field, so angle between these two is angle of current element and this magnetic field here, or the point P that we have taken. So if you will take this one, then if you will fold your hand your fingers, then the folding direction, as we are folding that fingers in, obviously we can fold it in this side. So if the current is flowing in this direction, then obviously the magnetic field that will be in inward direction. Clear? So in this way, we are just saying the direction of even vectors in cross product. Also, we can use the same method here for to find out the direction of magnetic field. So whenever the current is flowing in upward direction, then its direction for the magnetic field will be in this direction. And if it is flowing in downward direction, means in this opposite way, then that time magnetic field, you will say these fingers will tell the direction of magnetic field, that will be outward direction. So that time magnetic field will be outward. Clear, I think. Also, you can just talk about the anti-clockwise and clockwise direction by using the same method. So in this way, using right hand rule, we can say what will be the direction of the magnetic field in the Bio-Savart law. so after discussion of the Biot-Savart law, I think that is now clear. How can we find out the current, magnetic field due to any conductor that we have, and any shape of conductor you can have? You can have loop, you can have long conducting, infinitely long conducting wire, cylindrical wire you can have, or simple cylindrical conductor I should say. And next thing, like you have a spherical conductor, a spherical cell. So that, like the things we have discussed for the electric field, the, if current is flowing in them, then obviously they will also provide you magnetic field at some point. So we can calculate magnetic field there also. So here the next topic that we will discuss the next class, I think today we will not discuss that. Application of Biot-Savart law. Then first let's see today what is the relationship between mu zero and epsilon zero. Or simple, you can say that what is the relationship between permittivity and permeability of the medium here. So here I'm going to take the relationship between mu zero and epsilon zero, means permittivity and permeability of the free space. About that I'm going to just talk here. So for the free space case only I am going to talk for this case, and later in the chapter electromagnetic waves, students, I will tell you if we are changing our media, then that time speed of light will also change, and that topic we will discuss also in ray optics and wave optics later. We have to just study optics also here. So in this way every chapters are connected here. Just try to understand it little, one by one, every chapter. So for this case, as directly from the form, just values we will just calculate the relationship between them. For that case, as in the case of electric field, when Coulomb's law we were using, then that time the constant, proportionality constant there, that was k, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 for free space, and it has value that is 9 into 10 to the power 9. And if you will write its unit, so that unit was Newton meter square per Coulomb square. This was the unit of this one. Next thing here we have, that is mu 0 upon 4 pi. Just now we have discussed this one, and its value is obtained. This is 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla meter per ampere here. So if we will now take mu 0 into epsilon 0. So we can write in the place of mu 0 epsilon 0, mu 0 upon 4 pi into 4 pi epsilon 0. So from here 4 pi and 4 pi will be cancelled out. We can obtain mu 0 and epsilon 0. So let's write down the values here. So this is 10 to the power minus 7, and 1 upon this value is this, then obviously its value can be written as 9 into 10 to the power 9 here. And if you will just see here what is the unit that you have, so unit comes out to be, that I will tell you later what unit will be here. Obviously you can understand it by yourself. So this is 1 upon 9 into 10 to the power 16. This thing you will get from here. And also we can write it 3 into 10 to the power 8 whole square. And it means 3 into 10 to the power 8, that is the speed of light here. And its unit, if you will see from here, then its unit is obtained to be second square per meter square. After solving these three these units, you can understand or you can see it also. By dimensional analysis, you can also see it. So this will be obtained, this value here. So next, it means that we can write down mu 0 epsilon 0. Its value is obtained to be 1 upon c square. And finally, you can write C is equal to 1 upon root mu 0 into epsilon 0. So this is the relationship between the permeability and permittivity of free space, and that is connected by the speed of light. So here, as later you will also study that light is electromagnetic wave. and electromagnetic, both word means electric and magnetic, both properties will be there, and these two terms are representing also both properties. Permittivity we are getting when electric field we are talking about, and permeability is giving for that concept for the magnetic field. So it means both kind of fields will be joined at one place, and that is known as electromagnetism, and also C is electromagnetic wave. So these are just connected by this one. This meaning is very broad. Later, all the things we will discuss here. Only some part we are discussing. Like I just told you, even in starting, we have discussed only for electrostatic means when your charge is stationary at rest, and that time its effect, electric field, potential, and that whatever the things we have discussed there, that was totally electrostatic concept. Later, in current electricity, we have seen charge started to flow now. So, electrodynamic case were there, but we were discussed only for the electric effect of that moving charges there. What kind of electric effect it is showing? And later, for the after the experiment of Oersted, we have seen that it is also showing magnetic effect. Then we have just started to understand the magnetic effect. So, here we are just discussing electrodynamics one by one and its effect there. And after that, we will discuss even magnetodynamics also, and we will see that due to the movement of the magnet, electric field can also be generated. These both kind of fields are dependent on each. They have dependency here, so that dependency you can see later. So first, I think this is now clear. And if you will just see, it's a dimensional formula. So obviously, dimensional formula is, you know that this is Lt minus 1. Or if I will ask the dimensional formula for this one, so this is as 1 upon c square, and if you will write it, this one is equal to L minus 2 T2. So this is the dimension of this one. So sometimes this question is asked, and that is very important section for your examination point of view. So I think today whatever we have discussed about the chapter magnetic effect of current, student, that is clear. Only some basic topic we have discussed today. In next class, the very important topic that we will start from here, that is application of Bio-Savart law, and for due to different conductors, how can we find out the magnetic field using this law there. So for today, let's end the class here. Let's discuss the application.